now Carmina Burana. Karl Orff's cantata is one of the most popular of all 20th century works, and it was an instant success at its very first performance in Frankfurt in 1937. Its celebration of the pleasures of life and love is uninhibited, and so immediate that its popularity is never sagged. They never stop, do they? You can hear all the noise around me, and sometimes they do say something funny and people clap. So there we are, everyone getting, as I said earlier, a little frisky as we move towards the last night. Back to Carmina Burana. Well, the words were set by Orff and taken from a collection of 13th century poems uncovered about six centuries later in the Abbey of Benediktbeuern in the foothills of the Bavarian Alps near Munich, where Orff was born. The texts were written by various itinerant scholars in Low Latin and Early German, and they touch on every aspect, really, of human activity, religion, society, the state and the individual. The poems evoke the low life of medieval hard drinkers, lechers and dropouts, a good number of them apparently clerics. The work begins with an exuberant hymn to fortune, and it comes full circle with the return of that chorus at the end. The fickleness of the Wheel of Fortune, of course, was a favourite theme of these medieval scholars whose work was collected in the Carmina Burana. The work's directness in words and music is really its secret. This is all about earthy sensuality and sheer physical excitement. In fact, when Carmina Burana was last heard at the proms 20 years ago, there was some unscheduled excitement. In the middle of the performance, one of the soloists, Thomas Allen, was overcome by the heat on that occasion, and he fainted on stage. And then a rather extraordinary thing happened. A young singer, Patrick McCarthy, just popped up from the audience, and a few minutes later he took over the baritone role for the rest of the performance. Well, rather than tempt fate, I'll simply say that by prom standards, it's not that hot in here this evening, however lively it is. Joining the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra are the Bournemouth Symphony Chorus, the Wainfleet Singers, and members of Highcliffe Junior Choir, singled out by John Drummond a moment ago. The soloists will be the soprano Janice Watson, whose numbers come mostly in the courtly love section near the end, the countertenor James Bowman, he's got that famous song of the roasting swan, and Donald Maxwell. His solos include the drinking song of a medieval abbot. Once again, Brendan O'Brien, leader of the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra, takes his place. Now to conduct the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra in Karl Orff's Carmina Burana, here comes Richard Hickox, with the first of the soloists, Donald Maxwell. The others, Janice Watson and James Bowman, will make their own entrances as the work proceeds.
Deus et subtilis nuovo mundo reserà patiem aprilis an amorem proberat animus feris et iocundis imperat Deus pueris. Novitas in solemni fere et veris auctoritas iuver nos carere via screbet solitas et in tuo vere fides est et probitas tuum retinere. Ama me fideliter, fidem meam noda, me corde totaliter, et ex mente toda, sum presentialiter, absens in remota, quis quis amat taliter, volvitur in rota.
Thank you. Thank you. Imperius fiere vehementi, in amaritudine loco mementi, alto se materia, sinis elementi, similis folio, tecum tutto tenti, un cedendo proprium viro sapienti, supra ventra bonare, sede fondamenti, sonto se lo comparo, violamente, su di ore tramite, nunca permanenti. Thank you.
Summabas Pulcaniensis. Et consilium meum escum bibulisse, et insecta deci voluntas meest, et qui manem equisilit in taberna, post vesperam nudus egregietur, et sic denudatus vese clamabit. Sorsus visima nostre vita gaudia abstulisti omnia.
Vida, 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 vida sun contraria, figinum colloquia.
Sem donan tenebris, litere medi o
Sinefabilis,
spectatis labis,
sinefabilis, spectatis labis, si.
Yeah. mea. Domus, 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 amores,
Coperium, Coperium, Coperium.
Thank you.
That was Carl Orff's dramatic cantata Carmen Burana, played and sung by the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra and chorus, conducted by Richard Hickox. We were joined tonight by the Highcliffe Junior Choir from Bournemouth and the Wainfleet Singers from Winchester. Choirs now acknowledging the applause, and the three soloists are the soprano Janice Watts and the countertenor James Bowman and the baritone Donald Maxwell. Marvellous climax, really, to a year and more of centenary celebrations for this orchestra, which is such a lively and happy night here. An orchestra which had recently a remarkably successful first tour of the United States as part of their centenary celebrations, and which has just engaged an exciting new conductor in Jakob Kreutzberg to be their new principal conductor. And so with that final hymn of praise to fortune, we come to the end of tonight's BBC Prom from the Royal Albert Hall, given by the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra and Chorus, the Highcliffe Junior Choir and the Wainfleet Singers under their conductor, Richard Hickox, principal guest conductor of the Bournemouth Symphony Orchestra. Tomorrow night on Radio 3 you can hear a concert given by the BBC Symphony Orchestra as a tribute to one of its former chief conductors, Pierre Boulez. The next televised prom on Saturday is, of course, the last night itself, and that includes another choral spectacular, Walton's Belshazzar's Feast, as well as all the usual trappings to the climax of the prom season. Part 1 starts at 7.45, quarter to 8, on BBC 2 and Radio 3, and Part 2 follows at 9.20 on BBC 1 and Radio 3. The BBC Symphony Orchestra will be playing under its chief conductor, Andrew Davis, and Richard Baker will be here to introduce it. But for now, for the last time in this 100th prom season, it's good night from a very lively and happy Albert Hall, and me, James Maxwell.